Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrolaguy with another in the series. As I always stress, don't overlook the junk. I picked this up some time ago for $160. And as you can see, the cabinet is really, really poor. Most of the varnish is gone. It's been stored someplace damp. But I want you to see this. Under the lid, this machine is like new. I mean, it is in really, really fantastic condition. I have all the parts for it. This is an I.C.S. language machine with the repeater. You can see how this repeater works, of course. Let you go back just about 3 grooves per push. So, in any case, like the Edison D, which is, this is basically a D, with the addition of the A speed control. So it has an A motor in it. And these are really great machines. The problem with them, of course, is like the D, the E, and the F, they use pot metal mandrel bearings. And when I got this one, of course, the bearing was not only seized, it was literally turning to powder. So as I began to dismantle it to try to get the shaft out, the entire bearing came out of the machine, which was great. I didn't have to do anything to it at all, except clean up the hole. I'm waiting for the new mandrel bearing. It'll be here probably in the next 3 or 4 days. The mandrel bearing is just pressed in. You take a C-clamp and 2 blocks of wood and just press the new bearing into place and insert the mandrel, reassemble the gearing, and the machine's up and running. So I may just drop it into another case, but as you can see, the machine itself is just spectacular condition, and the motor is like new. I mean, it is just absolutely perfect. It runs well, it looks good, there's no rust, there's no damage, no pitting, nothing. I've got all the parts for it in there. The mandrel is bright and shiny, so in the next couple days I'm going to have a really nice ICS machine. What I'm going to do with it, I'm not really sure. I may put it on eBay. You know, this is basically a collector's machine, although it makes a great phonograph because it has a built-in speed control. So I'll be doing a video on installing the mandrel bearing, but just want you to see what you can get for a reasonable amount of money, especially when they're broken. And I've now reached the point where I only buy broken machines. A lot of machines on eBay, they say they're running, which they usually are if they say that. That doesn't mean they're running well. But it doesn't take a lot to get these things up and going. It's usually adjustments, lubrication, and cleaning. And occasionally you have to replace parts, yes. But as you can see, this machine is in really good condition. It's probably going to run. I've never run it. The motor runs great. But as far as the gearing is silent, absolutely silent. So it's going to be interesting to hear this machine running. So the new bearing will be here in the next couple days. If you need a mandrel bearing for the Edison C, D, E, F, etc., you can find it at APSCO, Antique Phonograph Supply Company. They're in New York. The new bearing is made of bronze, so it's never going to break down or rust or corrode. And you simply just press it in. And they're about $28. So that'll be here in the next few days. So we insert the new bearing, put the mandrel back in, put the gearing back on, put a belt on it, wind it up, and it's ready to go. As I said, I'll probably drop it into another case, but you can see what really great condition this machine is in. And so for the cost of the bearing and the trouble to take it apart, repair it, reassemble it, and get it running, you've got a really, really decent Edison phonograph in really spectacular condition for less than $200, not counting a reproducer, of course. But being an ICS machine, you don't see them very often, and you usually don't see them in this condition. I mean, as you can see, with just the slightest bit of cleanup on this bed plate, this thing is going to look just absolutely new. And it's in really, really decent shape. It was really inexpensive because it was majorly broken. And once this bearing's gone, that's it. The machine's never going to run again until you replace it. Like I said, in this case, I had the great fortune of the bearing literally turning to powder and falling out. All I had to do was clean out the hole. So when the new bearing arrives, I should be able to have this machine up and running in an hour or so. So I just wanted to do a quick video on it. As I said, when the bearing gets here, I'll do a video on pressing the bearing in. then reassembling the machine, throwing a belt on it, and see how it runs. I'm really looking forward to this. This was a really inexpensive machine in a really, really decent condition. The drawback, of course, is the case. But like I said, I've got another case, actually two or three, that I could drop this into. And then keep this for the machines that I keep myself. That's usually what I do. If I get a cabinet that is in really, really poor condition, I swap it out, keep the poor condition one myself. You know, the recorder and all the machines I use were junk machines from eBay. They don't have to look pretty. They just have to work well. That's my greatest concern. So don't know what I'm going to do with this yet, but it'll be running, well, as soon as the part gets here. Like I said, I'll do a video of installing the mandrel bearing. We'll reassemble it, throw a belt on it, and we're going to have a really, really nice I.C.S. machine that has a working repeater. And I have some original language cylinders. You know, and this machine is designed to run at 90 RPM. Which is the whole idea of the speed control. If you're going to be listening to a language cylinder, you can speed it up, you can slow it down. It'll also play standard cylinders, but you really have to crank it up. But in any case, it's going to be fun to play with. It's a really nice machine. It's in really decent shape. So I'll be doing a video on installing that mandrel bearing. I ordered it day before yesterday, so it should be here within a week anyway. And then I said it's just a quick matter of pressing it in, reassembling the machine, and throwing a belt on it. And we're going to have a really nice ICS machine to play with. So, as always, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thanks for watching.